just realized that I need this, otherwise you can't hear me. So welcome to the day two of Rise from Within, 3-day event. So yesterday I guided you and invited you to feel your body, and there is my invitation again. So is it easier for you to start feeling your body right now? When you're sitting, when you're touching yourself, do you feel the sensations? And do you also find a kind of calmness or groundedness that comes with that? We practiced that yesterday, and it's an ongoing practice. And you might notice that today, a different place in your body feels good or calm, and that's okay. And it doesn't have to be a big place. It can be like a fingertip, for example, whatever works for you. And I'm also curious if you tried to look at an emotion in three different ways that we practiced yesterday, and maybe something came up between yesterday and today, and please share in the comments. Today, I will go deeper on emotions and the idea that emotions are energy that show up as sensations in your body. So you might have heard that emotions don't mean anything. They are not a representation of reality, right? It's not that something happens and this automatically for every person leads to the same emotion, but it's your reaction to something that happens on the outside, or often it's actually something that you think, right? You can think about something joyful and you feel joyful, and really nothing has changed in your life except that you thought about something that made you feel a certain way, which comes with certain sensations. So joy, for me, I'm sure you've seen it on the video right now. I straightened my spine, it got bigger, like my body relaxed, but also like took up more space just by itself. And it's like this, right? It's instant. So emotions can be seen as sensations in your body. So for joy, for example, let's see. For me, joy feels like an upward stream of energy. It's like as if something is moving upwards inside of me. It starts in my chest area and is expanding outwards and upwards. And for you, it might feel different. Maybe you want to share, how does joy feel like in your body? What's the quality that comes with it? What's the actual sensations in your body, right? That's something a bit more tangible than an emotion. Yeah. And along with this, when we feel sensations, there is also an aliveness to it, right? There is something going on. There is a movement in our body. It's aliveness, really, for me. And for me, often when I feel anger, this aliveness is very very easy to spot, because with anger, I'm also getting bigger, like my muscles tense up and my focus is there, right? And I'm ready to act. So there is a lot of energy that comes from anger and I'm present, right? I'm ready to move, I'm ready to talk. So how does that land for you? That anger can be seen as aliveness, or any emotion can be seen as aliveness. And as we've seen yesterday, you can choose how to view this emotion, right? You can choose to be overtaken by the emotion. And like something might just stir up inside of you when I say you can choose to be overtaken. Because when you're overwhelmed or overtaken by the emotion, you of course don't like have the impression that you choose it, right? And yet, as we've seen yesterday, you can take a step back, like an inner step back, and choose to distance yourself from the emotion, to push it away, or to find a more neutral relationship with the emotion. And of course, that doesn't always work in every situation, especially in the heat of the moment, and especially when you're threatened. So when there's a threat or fear response. So the fight, flight, freeze response. Because when you're in fight, flight, freeze, you're not in your rational brain, right? It's actually impossible for you to rationally choose what to do, because other areas of your brain take over and decide for you. But luckily, most of the time, we're not in fight, flight, freeze. And we do have at least some portion of the rational brain locked on and active, and we can use this to choose how we want to react or respond to the situation, to the emotion, to the sensation that's inside of us. So yeah, are you still feeling your body? Was something activated? Was some emotion triggered, activated? How does that feel like in your body? Let's use something that's like right there, here with you in this moment, and work with this, because I'm gonna guide you into a practice that shows you how emotions and the sensations can actually be pleasurable. Right? You ready for that? I think it's a really, really juicy one. So we work with whatever sensations go on inside of your body right now. And then you can start to touch your body in a way that feels good. Just maybe calm, maybe gentle touch, something that feels good. And these are also sensations. And then you might also feel the other sensations that you labeled as uncomfortable. And now I invite you to get very curious about these sensations and remove the label from them. So there might be a tightness, and that's just a tightness, right? There might be a coolness or coldness somewhere, and that's just that, right? It doesn't have to mean anything. And can you be present with these sensations that you just a minute ago labeled as uncomfortable or unpleasant, and just feel them as they are, as sensations? So what happens? Maybe the sensations shift. This might shift into like a more relaxation. Or maybe you realize that they are just sensations, right? And you probably know, either from like just general knowledge or because you engage in kink yourself, that pain is pain, right? And pain can be pleasurable when you experience it in a certain setting and with a certain mindset and a certain label, right? So first of all, you need to feel safe for you to do that. And that's why we practiced feeling the safety and the calmness and peace in your body, first and foremost, to have this bodily resource inside of you. And then you might be able to feel this maybe tension inside of your body and say, okay, actually, I kind of like it. Am I allowed to like the rage or the anger or the shame or the judgment? Is that okay? It is. You choose. And now what you can also do is to find the energy behind the sensations. So there is this aliveness underlying the sensation, and you can, it might be a bit of a stretch, but just give it a try. You might be able to feed this quality of aliveness to the pleasurable sensations. So just like, touch yourself again. And as if like you're taking the energy of the tightness and fuel the pleasure with that. That's another way to approach that. Just give it a try. And if you're getting frustrated, there is so many more sensations to work with. Isn't that wonderful? And again, you can choose how to see those sensations. What's the sensation of frustration? I think for me, I don't feel it right now, but I think it's a tightness in my throat. I don't like it, you know, and I can still get curious about it. So for me, it comes down to the question, if you're willing to feel the sensations that come from emotions, but also touch, for example, are you willing to feel those sensations and this expression of aliveness inside of you, no matter how it shows up, no matter how it presents you? Are you willing to be present with that and not run away from it? Because when you're present with that, you have much more options to act, right? And you might also notice that there is a calmness coming from it. I mean, like, okay, I can feel that. I don't need to run away, or I don't need to control it to go away, right? I can be with it and kind of stand my ground. I'm here. The emotions, yes, they are part of my experience. I'm not the emotion, but I'm experiencing the emotion. And I feel them in a certain way. Why not? Right? Why not? And I can still think and act how I choose. So let me know in the comments if this process worked for you, or if this was a bit frustrating for you. Like, again, that's fine. But if you like didn't get it, I need to explain it a different way. And I want you to get it. And I invite you to start with like being present with the sensations and start from there. And that's really a huge, huge step already. So if you have any questions, comments, ahas, please share them either below the video or in the separate post that I'm going to put up in my Facebook group. And if you want to go deeper and work on your specific emotions that continually come up, like there's probably a pattern, an emotional pattern running in your life, and you want to be able to look at this in a different way, I'm here to help you. So just reach out to me, write me a message, or you can also click the link on where I explain my coaching package. Maybe this is something that's suitable for you, that you want to be, you're interested in and want to learn more about. So thank you for showing up, and see you tomorrow. Bye.